Hi, I'm Lara, and this is Trip Trinity Trilogy. Today, I'm doing something different, and I'm showing off one of the felt storybooks I made for the 4-H Veil. Today, I'm showing off Hansel and Gretel, the first of the felt books I made. So here are my wonderful books all set up together. You can see I have the champion ribbons on them because I'm vain and I wanted you to see it. So I have all three of them stacked right here, and I'm gonna have a video for each one, and I'm gonna start with Hansel and Gretel now. Since this is a BookTube channel, I thought this would be a fun book related to craft to show off. So I thought I'd give a quick little explanation of what the felt book is and why I made these felt books and what they're for. So I made these for the 4-H Farm Fair. The section in which I entered it was childcare. So for the childcare section, you're supposed to make something for kids. So I made little felt books that kids could read and play with. So I picked fairy tales, and then I made dolls. So then they could go around and read it and then act out the scenes with the characters for fun. So I thought it was a cute idea because we had some like these when I was little. They were a little different and didn't have stickers on them, but I thought it would be a fun idea, and it's about for ages 5 and up, a kid that won't pick off the pieces and eat them pretty much. So to give some quick explanation of how I made it, I just got big sheets of felt, stiff ones for the covers that matched, and then floppy ones for the inside, and I used them as the pages for the book. Now, I used fabric marker for these type of things, and then I used scrapbook stickers too to help decorate it. I cut holes in each page and then used ribbons to tie the spine, and then for the words, I typed up the story on the computer and then printed it on fabric paper and then cut it with these jagged lines. Now you'll notice these pages are stuck together, and that is because I used a blanket stitch, which is just a type of stitch, to stitch them together for each page. And that's generally what I did and how I made these felt books. And I think they're really cute. They're pretty fun. I know I played with felt books, not these ones, when I was little, and I really enjoyed them. So I'll get right into the story now. Now, I'll show you each of the felt characters I made for the felt book. They're pretty cute, if I do say so myself. So this is Hansel, and this is his sister Gretel. They're the cutest of these ones. Well, obviously. Then here's a really weird, hairy looking woodcutter father who really needs a shave. I made this a couple years ago when I was younger, so spare me the critiques, or not, whatever. This is their angry stepmother and her matching socks because she's stylish AF. And then here's the evil, cranky old witch. Now I'll just give you a quick tour of the felt book. Once upon a time, there was a poor family made up of a woodcutter / father, a stepmother, and two kids, a son named Hansel and the daughter named Gretel. One night, the stepmother told the woodcutter tomorrow he had to get rid of the kids, for there was not enough food, but Hansel and Gretel heard her. Here's the next one, when they're in the woods. I know in the original fairy tale, they go twice, but in this version, I made it once so there wouldn't be as many pages. Here's the trees, and there's a crow, and those are the breadcrumbs, but oh no, he's eating them. Next day, the woodcutter said they were going to collect wood. As he led Hansel and Gretel into the forest, the two kids dropped breadcrumbs to mark their way home. When they fell asleep while resting, the woodcutter left. They tried to take the breadcrumb path, but the crows had eaten it. Oh no. Here's the epic gingerbread house. I used a lot of felt in this one and scrapbook stickers, trying to make it look as cool as possible. Hansel and Gretel wandered around the forest, trying to find their way back home. After 2 days, they came to a gingerbread house. They were starving, so they started to eating like crazy. An old woman came out. She invited them in and fed them. Then she gave them soft beds to sleep in. And then, oh no, inside the gingerbread house. It's getting intense. There's the cage I made, and it opens, so you can put Hansel in it. I made it so he'd have to kneel, but you know, whatever. There you go, Hansel, where you belong. This one obviously has a lot of words because I tried to make it as minimal amount of pages as possible. As you can see, this little book says How to Cook Kids, and it opens. Obviously, she has great handwriting, and then there's a little treasure chest, and then there's also the fireplace, which opens so you can shove the old witch in there. Of course, you have to crumple on the ball. But the old woman was not as sweet as she seemed. She was actually an evil witch. She locked Hansel in a cage and planned to eat him. She forced Gretel to give him rich meals to fatten him. However, she had bad eyesight, so she told him to stick his finger out to see if he was plump enough. But instead, he would stick out a chicken bone, so she would think he was too thin to eat. Oh no, I made a typo. There should be two O's right there. This went on for a month, until the witch finally decided to eat both Hansel and Gretel anyway. The witch asked Gretel to check the oven and to see if it was hot enough. Another typo. Gosh, I got like first place and see grand champion in this. How? I have two typos. They have low standards. No, I'm just kidding. I was young though, so be gentle. Gretel could easily see its flames from across the room, so she pretended not to understand. The witch stuck her head in the oven to demonstrate, and Gretel quickly pushed the witch in and closed the doors. That's pretty violent, Gretel. Gretel freed Hansel. They started roaming around the house, and to their great surprise, they found a chest full of pearls and precious stones. They stuffed their pockets full and set off for home. Now, the one scene that's often forgotten, the giant duck scene. Cha-cha! And fish, but they're not relevant. Hansel and Gretel were trying to get home when they came to a lake. Gretel saw a duck and asked it if it would give them a ride across. It happily agreed and gave them a ride on its back. When they got to the other side, they could see their house. Again, I did not make this up. This is the original fairy tale, or at least the version I had. So, giant duck. And then their happy house on the outside with the window and all the stuff and the bird. It's all beautiful and happy, sunshiny. Yay! Hansel and Gretel ran home and reunited with their father, the woodcutter. They found out their stepmother had died, making their reunion a happy one because screw your stepmom. Hansel, Gretel, and the woodcutter used the witch's jewels to bring their worries to an end, and they lived happily ever after. The end. Then closed storybook and produced by cows, because that was something I always put on my cards when I was little, so I put on my felt book too. That's my Hansel and Gretel felt book. This is my second favorite one that I made. It got first place and I think intermediate champion and grand champion. I hope you liked the video and the storybook, and I will be making two more episodes, one for each of the felt books. Later!